Admin Companion is an AI that executes complex tasks for you directly from within your Linux shell. In this video, I will show you the amazing capabilities of Admin Companion to deploy a web application into an Apache 2 web server. I have created a virtual machine with a Debian system on it. And I've also installed Apache 2 already, but we don't have anything in the web directory. Also, we do not have any sites enabled right now. Neither available nor enabled. Additionally, I have created a very simple Hello World application in Python, which doesn't do anything else than just return Hello World, and a WSGI file that just connects Apache 2 with the Python application. Now we would like Admin Companion to install this application to Apache 2 so we can call it via an HTML request via Apache 2. To do so, we invoke Admin Companion with the command AI. At this point, it is important to understand that Admin Companion has a huge knowledge about Debian, Apache 2, infrastructures, and so on. But of course, it does not know anything about our specific system. So we need to provide all the information that is needed for Admin Companion to do the job. So first of all, we just let it have a look in the current directory so it knows about the structure of our application. Once it has done this, it can deploy the application. We of course need to tell it where it should be put into. Next, we would like it to create a virtual environment over there. Once this has been done, it should make Apache 2 being able to connect to it. And the last step should be that we let Apache 2 listen on port 5004. Okay, let's give it a try. It now thinks, what should I do with this request? And it says, I would like to execute this command, ls-l. And we have here the question, okay to proceed. This question, okay to proceed, is created by a security layer that we have developed around the AI so that the AI can never execute any command without your explicit confirmation. So we say, yes, let's execute that command. So we can see the output and Admin Companion can see this output and integrate that information into the next steps. So in this case, it knows now, okay, it's a Python application, so we copy the application to the destination directory. At the next step, we ask to create a virtual environment. And yes, this is to create the virtual environment. Then Admin Companion detected the requirements.txt, and due to the general knowledge about Python, it knows the requirements.txt file contains the modules that we need to execute the program. So it goes and installs these requirements. It tried to source the environment and saw the source doesn't work. So we don't have the source available at that point. So it goes now another way and just goes directly into the directory and does the installation from within the directory, which is also okay. We see the dependencies are already satisfied due to Python global configuration. Now the next step is that admin companion creates a virtual host, which then connects to the app.wsgi file, which is also good, and it puts it into a configuration 00 default. Now it can see we have a permission denied here because it cannot create this, it cannot directly write here. So it goes and tries into another way. It creates a bash file and with a command to execute that. And once it has now created the default configuration site, it now goes into having this site being enabled in Apache 2. At the next step, it changes the port.conf to not listen on port 80 anymore because we wanted to have it on port 5004, so it replaces this one. As a next step, it wants to restart Apache 2. Now it says, as a conclusion, the application has been deployed, the virtual environment was created, and the required packages were installed. Apache 2 was configured to connect to the application via WSGI and to listen on port 5004. The configuration has been reloaded, so the new settings should be active now. So we ask it now, please check it, whether it's working. So please check the application on port 5004. So it knows it can use the current command to do so. And interestingly, we have an internal server error. So something is wrong. It doesn't work. So admin companion knows that it should have a look into the Apache 2 error log and sees here what's happening. And it's something on the mod.wsgi file. And it now looks into the directory, the web directory, to see what's the situation there and goes deeper into the app.wsgi to see what is inside there. And this is an interesting point, that it goes beyond what we requested. So we said install the application, but it now really goes and repairs the application itself. So it now does a change in the app.wsgi and replaces here the correct path so that it can work. And we say, yes, please do this. And it now has again here a permission denied. So it tries again with a sudo, the same command. And once this is being done, it restarts Apache 2 again. Which takes a while. Now it takes that information and says, okay, let's test now again. So it tests it. And indeed, we have hello world here done. So it says now conclusion, application is now working correctly and returning hello world on port 5004. The issue was the incorrect Python path in the WSGI configuration and has been resolved. What you saw is a sample of how admin companion translates a natural language request of two or three sentences into a complex chain of commands to install a Python application into Apache 2, and even goes beyond that and repairs the application itself. This is how admin companion can tremendously help us to improve system administration efficiency. This is especially true if we are talking about commands that we do not use every day, where we would have to search in the documentation or in the internet to know about the exact parameters. Here, Admin Companion is much quicker to help us. If you would like to test Admin Companion yourself, you can register for free on admin-companion.ai.